Hi friends, welcome to the VARC with Harpreet Kaur Dhoti. Today's topic is sectional questions, guys. So we are doing what is known as PYQs every day, and these are previous year's question papers. Today we are going to do a CAT 2020 slot 1 question paper, guys. So please join me for this particular session. Bugs Bounty is an opportunity for learners to report any kind of inappropriate content in the video. My name is Harpreet Kaur Dhoti. I've done a master's in English literature, diploma in journalism. 17 years of teaching experience is what I have. I've trained students for exams like the CAT, MAT, ZAT, SNAP, PGCET, banking, GRE, GMAT, SAT, ACT, and TOEFL. Today I'm an educator on hashtag CATLiveDaily. Telegram channel livedaily.me/chat. Guys, my Telegram channel is Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy CAT. Good morning, Patel, Lakshman, Pratibha. Hi, guys. So we have two kinds of subscriptions. We have the plus and we have the iconic. If you take the plus, you have live classes, weekly tests, structured courses, unlimited access. But if you take the iconic, you have much more. You have personal guidance, study planner, study material, expert guidelines, and test analysis too. Ask a doubt is another feature that we have. And plus subscription prices are given to you here, guys. 6 months ka subscription hai, 12 months, 24 months. Also, we have the iconic 12 months, 24 months. And if you use call 10 for any of these subscriptions, you will get a 10% discount if you use call 10, guys. So are you ready? Welcome to the hashtag marketing professionals do one-stop destination. Crack management exams, please go ahead and subscribe. CAT iconic one-to-one live mentorship program is very good for the benefit of students. You can speak with the mentor, you can clear doubts, you can discuss concepts, exam strategy, build a plan, and book your slots also. Enroll now, guys. Many batches are starting very soon. A limited edition offer is there for the benefit of the students. 12 months subscription, 3 months off. 24 months subscriptions, 3 months free. So please go ahead and enroll. Unacademy Combat, as you know, I'm just reminding you, happens on Sundays at 12 p.m. If you want to win a scholarship, you will get a scholarship from rank 1 to 200, guys. Please use score 10. Scan on this particular code and you can enroll. Skill Builder is also there for the benefit of our students. 15 questions, 30 minutes, 7 p.m. Yes, campus placement IT jobs is also important. Please look at this slide closely, those who find it relevant. Plus classes, guys. Plus classes ke jo features hain, they are better than the YouTube features. Why? Because you can interact in these live classes with the educator. You can use the polls for the learners. You can raise your hand. You will never miss a class because you will get a notification from the educator. Lecture notes will also be given to you in the form of PDFs. Anywhere, anytime, you can take your classes, guys. So I take plus classes at 11:30 a.m. Today's class is going to be long. So today's special class is at 12 p.m. Okay, write it down here. 12 p.m. today, guys. Aaj dopahar ko at 12 p.m. we are taking a class on the special because today's class might be long because I'm doing the entire section. I'm doing RC and VA of the CAT 2020 paper. Yes, Ankit, Skill Builder, you have to go to the Unacademy Learner app and check for the Skill Builder. Right. So, aaj karne hai, guys, 26 questions with me, RC, VA, full section. So, this might go long, this class. So, that is why I have scheduled my special class at 12 p.m. At 5 p.m. is my plus class, guys. I am doing CR. And also for the benefits of the learners, verbal ability batch starting tomorrow on the 11th at 5 p.m. So those who want to join the plus classes, please go ahead and join with Core 10. A very good morning to all my learners. Are you ready, guys, for this sectional test? Yes, we are doing the whole VARC section of the CAT 2020 paper. So let us go. Varsha, today I am doing para jumbles. Today para jumbles. Okay. So guys, let us go. We have passages in the beginning. First passage itself is telling you that the passages are followed by questions. You have four choices, read the passage and answer. Now this is the first passage, and as you notice, har saal there is one particular passage on an animal. Some time back it was seahorses, and this one is talking about the northern elephant seal population. You know what seals are, right? Okay, so read this paragraph very closely and let us try to answer the questions. We will also decide what is the difficulty level of the questions. Is the question difficult? Is it easy? And how should we approach this question is what I'm going to tell you, because you can get these papers anywhere and you can find the answers also, but the point is the explanation. Explanation is very important. Abhishek, Unacademy Learner app pe hogi. So you can download the Unacademy Learner app, and if you go to CAT courses, you will get special classes. Is that fine? Yes, so let's start reading the passage, guys. Done. Abhishek, you can take Arun Sharma's book, but also you can take the Plus subscription. We are putting out a lot of good content on it. Every day there is a lot of content put out by educators. So you can follow the classes and you can crack the questions. So Unacademy Plus subscription le lo and use score 10, you will get a 10% discount. If you want personal attention, you can take the Iconic also. Done. Lakshya, you have to do a lot of reading comprehension. and parajumbles. Yes, are you done? Can I go to the questions, guys? We have almost 4 questions to answer on this particular passage. Are you clear with what the passage is trying to say? Did you understand the passage? Okay, let us go to the question, guys. First question, from this passage it can be inferred. Now this is a question which is difficult. It comes, so you have easy, medium and difficult questions. We are going to try to answer this question, which I'm going to tell you which question is easy, which one is difficult, which one is approachable and how to approach it. So you are coming to the class for the explanation. I'm sure all of you can find the material anywhere that you want to. So it can be inferred that the call pulse rate of the male northern elephant seals in the southern rookeries was faster because what was the reason? Now this is an inference question and it is asking you to mark the option that suggests why is the reason for the call rate of male northern elephants in the southern rookeries was faster. Now you can find this, where first you mark the answer, then I will tell you how to find the answer. Yes, let me see you mark the answer. No, he is talking about the pulse rate. Lakshman, you have to answer the question which is asking you about the pulse rate. Yes, you are not talking about they have migrated to southern rookeries to recolonize them. So, answer therefore, if you look at the second paragraph, last line. Yes, what is he saying here? It was precisely on the more recently colonized that the tempos of the male vocal showed stronger differences to the ones that the founder colonies. And he is also telling you that this led He's saying this led Lee Beowulf and his collaborator Lewis to deduce. Deduce means to infer that the dialects were perhaps a result of isolation over time after the breeding sites had been recolonized. Perhaps a result of isolation over time. Right? So that is why he says that the first settlers of Anno New would have had by chance calls with low pulse rates. On other sites where scientists found faster pulse rates, the opposites could have happened. Seals with faster rates could have happened to arrive first. So if the pulse rate of the elephant seals in the southern rookeries was faster, it was because the seals with faster pulse rates might have been the original settlers. They may be the original settlers. So C is the best choice. This is A cannot be the answer because it is talking about a situation when The pulse rates in the case of A cannot be the answer because the pulse rates of the seals in the southern Rookies would have been slower, not faster. So it's just saying the opposite of what the paragraph is saying, right? And in the case of B also, here the question is migration to southern rookeries and not from southern rookeries. To southern rookeries, right? And D has no evidence to the paragraph whatsoever. Therefore, this is what you derive from the second paragraph. It's not B. C is the answer. Are you satisfied with the explanation? Okay, let's go to the second question, guys. Which of the following conditions would have ensnared that male northern elephant seal dialects did not disappear? Which of the following would have ensured? That means it would have made sure that male northern elephant dialect seals did not disappear. So this is a factual passage, so I think it is medium difficulty. You can find the fact in the paragraph itself. Yes, very good. Binay Raj giving me the correct answer. The call tempo of individual migrant male seals changed to match the average tempo of resident male seals in the host colony. Now, why is this a factual or data-based question? Why is it a data-based question is because it is mentioned in the first sentence of the last paragraph. Yes. So he says, as the population continued to expand and the islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population, the calls in all locations would have eventually regressed to the average pulse rate of the founder colony. Do you see this question, guys? Yes. Therefore, this answer will be A. A is the correct answer, right? Yeah. And this is a very simple concept. Now, what is it that will ensure that male northern seals dialects does not disappear? It disappeared because the average changed because of migrant seals. As and more seals came, the average regressed to the pulse rate of the founder colony. To make the situation opposite, the call tempo of the individual migrant seal should have changed to match the average tempo of resident male seals of the host colony. So that is why answer is A. Right? Yeah, the islands kept on receiving immigrants from the original population and the average pulse rate changed to match the founder colony, not the host colony. That's why the host colony's dialects disappeared. And therefore, the answer is 1. These are not the answer. This is mentioned in the first sentence of the last paragraph. Last para, you take off time, guys, and read this very, very closely. First sentence explains this. So you can take screenshots of this particular passage and read the options. A is the one which explains this. Okay. We don't need to eliminate options because these are not answering the question. There was one more founder colony. The call tempo seals in host colonies changed to match the average of immigrant male seals. He's not saying that. And there was one more surviving colony with same average call tempo is not answering the question. Answer is A. Okay, let's go to question number 3. Which of the following sums up the overall history of transformation of northern male northern elephant seal calls? sums up the overall history of transformation. So this is what is known as an easy question. This is the easiest question in the passage. So it's trying to tell you. Yes, first you mark the answer. Yes, read the last sentence of the passage, guys. Yes, what is the answer to question number 3? Yes, Shivangi and Binay giving me correct answers. Yes, it's not D, guys. This is saying great regional variety. A and D is saying great regional variety, which is not the answer. Now, let us look at the last sentence of the passage. What is he trying to say here is, while 50 years ago the drumming pattern was quite simple, dialects denoted just a change in tempo, Cassie explained that the calls reported today are more complex, sometimes featuring doublets and triplets. And he's saying modern males exhibit individual variety and their calls are more complex. Can you see this? This is a very, very data-based question. Right? Very data-based question. So if you look at the last part, it is giving you an answer very clearly here, guys, that the answer is going to be C. They have transformed, exhibiting simple composition, less individual variety and greater regional variety. So what was simple and less individual became a complex composition, great individual variety and less regional variety. Okay? Yeah. And that's why this is the best option. It's easy to capture. There is more of individual variety, less of regional variety. So the passage says, in the decades that followed, scientists noticed that the geographical variations reported in 1969 were not obvious anymore. Yeah, it should be less regional variety, not great. Do you notice this word, guys? It should be less regional variety. This is not the answer. Owing to migrations in the aftermath, exhibited a gradual increase until they matched the tempo. This is incorrect. So answer is C. Are you able to identify? Are you able to identify the answers, guys? Okay, let us go to the next question. Question number 4. All of the following can be inferred from Lee Bioff's study as described in the passage except. So it's an inference question. All can be inferred except. Except questions are very common in the CAT examination, guys. It is slightly difficult question. This one is difficulty level is high because you have to answer the question by elimination. You have to mark the answer. They cannot be inferred. Yes, so let us look at question number 4 and can you tell me what is the answer? You have to go back to the passage and eliminate, guys. Yeah, you have to pick the answers from the passage. Now, let us look at A. Male northern elephant seals might not have exhibited dialects that they had not become nearly extinct in the 19th century. Now, it can be inferred that the seals exhibited dialects because the population was isolated, and the isolation was the result of the seal population being almost on the verge of extinction. But these numbers were small and the isolation happened. As the population grew, there was a migration from different places, and this results in the differences of dialects. So A can be inferred. Yeah, A can be definitely inferred from the passage. B can be inferred from the para that talks about the seals. No, anonyo seals. It says that the average pulse rate increased in the 1970s till the dialect disappeared. So this can be inferred. This is mentioned in the passage, guys. Doesn't he say that it increased in the 1970s till the disappearance of the dialects? This is mentioned. B is also mentioned. Now answer is going to be C. It is a wrong inference because the influx might have resulted in the pulse rate of the seals averaging to that of the isle, not exceeding. Now, what is important here is exceed makes this incorrect. The word exceed is a wrong inference, right? This is what makes it wrong. And D is also true because changes in population had no effect on the call pulse rate of individual northern. So changes in the population did not make any changes. The individual call rate did not change, but the migration made all the difference by ensuring influx of seals with higher pulse rates, thus increasing the average pulse rate. You got it, guys? You're finding it very tough. I can see students leaving. Okay, this is the simplest passage, guys. Very, very simple passage that we have. Try to read this one. Yes, many of the questions in this passage can be answered very easily, guys. You should get all the answers correct in this particular passage. In this passage, you should get all the answers correct. Done. Okay, let's go to the questions. All the questions are very easy, guys. Question number five. What do we need to do? From the passage, what do you infer? What do we need to do? What is the practice we need to follow in order to set the grammar right? What is the central idea of the passage? Manthan, that is what you think. Is the author saying, is he saying that we need, is he saying that we should break grammar rules? It's just the opposite of what the paragraph is saying. Is the paragraph saying that we should break grammar rules? What is the last sentence saying? Always read. Grammar is the pole you grab to get your thoughts up on their feet and walking. Just remind yourself that rocks explode, Janes transmit, mountains float, plums defy. What he's trying to tell you is that we need grammar. He's saying grammar is important. Yeah, grammar is important. Yes, answer is D. D is the availability of a language software will standardize the rule and grammar as an aid to writers. Right, the critique of standardized rule of punctuation and capitalization is very specific. It's only talking about two aspects. Paragraph is talking about the whole of grammar, not only punctuation and capitalization. Right, in the case of B, a campaign demanding the writers is against grammar. It's the opposite of what the passage is trying to say. A creative writing course that focuses on, again, just a writing course is not enough. We need to learn the whole of grammar. And therefore, the answer is D. If there is a language software which helps us to correct grammar based upon the rules, guys, we will be good because grammar is important. Grammar is the pole, he's saying, that we can climb on. Yeah, this doesn't even mention grammar. Breaking of grammatical rules, he says. Okay? Okay, guys, let's go to the next one. Take a noun, put it with a verb, and you have a sentence. It never fails. Rocks explode. None of the following statements can be seen as similar except. Now understand what is the paragraph trying to say. It's an analogy type of questions. So you bring two different things together and you have a new thing. Two different things. Rocks explode, Jane transmits, mountains float. You bring two different things. He's saying, and you get a new thing. So what is the answer, guys? Find the one where you bring two things and you get a new thing. You need to practice a lot, Aman. So take a noun, put it with a verb, and you get a new thing. Yes, Radha, very good. So answer is D, because vegetable is a noun. What is he saying? Vegetable is noun, spices is the verb. And the result is a new dish. There is no analogy there in 3 at all. You don't understand the relevance of same sports equipment. So question says take any noun, but in three we are taking a collection of people. Now this one is logically flawed because without a verb we can't have a sentence. A group of nouns arranged in a row becomes a sentence. Without a verb we cannot have a sentence. Now this looks like very close, but planting an apple tree alone in the field will not make the field an orchard. Just by putting an apple tree, you don't get an orchard. But if you combine a vegetable with spices, you will get a new dish. Right, guys? So therefore, the answer is D. Okay, let us look at 7. Why not B? Shivangi, a group of nouns arranged in a row becomes a sentence. In the case of B, without a verb, we cannot have a sentence. There is no verb here. You get this, Shivangi? Okay, let us go to the 7th one. All the statements can be informed except. Yes, noun plus verb is a sentence. Seventh one, guys, what is the answer? All the following can be inferred. He is talking about subject predicate. No, see, when you are writing, sorry. Yeah, the vegetable is a noun. Right. By itself, it cannot make a new dish, but you add spices to it. So two things are added. Put is the verb, put some spices, and you get a dish. Right? Okay, let us go to question number 7. Answer is definitely A, because subject verb agreement is mentioned. Grammar police is a metaphor for critics. Sentences do not always have to be complete. All of them are mentioned. So if he's saying that the author is in favor of grammar and it is grammar that helps us to form complete sentences, how can the passage implies that sentences need not be complete? It has to be the other way around. So the answer is 1. Right? Four also can be inferred. Sentences do not always have to be complete. Let me take you to the passage. So rocks explode, Jane transmits, they are all perfect sentences. Many lies like such thoughts look less rational, but even the stronger ones have a kind of poetic weight. Simplicity of construction is useful, right? Yeah, D is also mentioned. Now, these are sentences. They are sentences which may not be complete. So, he is also telling you here in this particular sentence that sentences, how can you be certain they are doing well? How will you know if they are doing ill for that matter? Answer is that you can't, you won't. One who does grab the rudiments find a comforting simplicity in its heart where there needs to be only nouns, the words, the names, the verbs, the words that act. So that is something which can be inferred. D can be inferred. So It is ensure that sentences remain simple is not mentioned anywhere, guys. Grammar has a wider purpose. It's not just to ensure that sentences remain simple. Okay, which one of the best quotes best captures the main concern of the passage? What is the main central idea? This is known as central idea of the passage. Yes, very easy question. Only one answer and you should get this one correct. What is the main idea? Main concern is main idea. C is mentioned. Grammar police. He is talking about grammar police, right? Policing of grammar. I'll show you. Yeah, the grammar police aren't going to take you and going to come and take you away. So it is mentioned. Definitely it is mentioned. Yes, what is rules of rhetoric? Rules of forming sentences. Rhetoric is normally exaggeration. Yes, which is the one which best captures the main concern of the paragraph? Yes, Radha, Pratik, all giving me correct answers. This is the easiest question till now, guys. Answer is bad grammar produces bad sentences. So we need to improve grammar. This is what he is trying to tell us. These are all specific questions. These are all ideas which are very, very specific. So when you are looking for the main idea, you have to see an option which covers all parts of the passage. You can't look for something which is giving you specific or minute details. Look for something which is there in all parts of the passage, right? Okay, which of the statements, if false, could be seen as supporting the arguments in the passage? Why not C? Because again, it is a specific answer. It's only not talking about nouns and verbs. It is talking about all of grammar. It's talking about modifiers. It is talking about parallelism, everything, right? So C cannot be the answer. These are specific options. One paragraph is talking about this. Rakhi, I take classes at 10 a.m. on YouTube every day in the morning. I have a special class at 12 today. Normally, I take at 11:30 a.m. Yes, guys. Let us go to 9. Which of the following statements, if false, could be seen as supporting the arguments in the passage? Vineet, it is more personalized in the iconic. Yes. You can have one-to-one mentorship. You can talk to your educators. You can plan your studies. You can do some strategy session. You will get materials also. Yes. So it's more personalized. That's what I can say. Special class, Unacademy learning app download karo. Unacademy learning app you can download from App Store or Google Store. Question number 9, guys. Yes, this is again like an accept question. Answer is perish the thought that complete sentences necessarily need nouns and verbs is saying the opposite of what the paragraph is saying. Now, if you look at this, we have to pick a choice which when falsified supports the arguments. One is supporting the author. One is supporting understanding of grammar helps a writer decide if he's writing well or not. So it supports. Regarding grammar, women writers tend to be more attentive to method and accuracy is what he's trying to tell you here, which is again correct. Second one is falsified. Second one says that one must not think that nouns and verbs are necessary for complete sentences when falsified means that nouns and verbs are necessary for complete sentences. Four is irrelevant. This one is irrelevant because it disregards the rule of rhetoric, has nothing to do with the passage's chief concern, which is grammar. So therefore, the answer is B, guys. Is it fine? Okay, let us go to question number 10. Are you ready to do the passage or you want me to go to other questions? Can we do the verbal ability section, guys, and skip two passages, or you want me to do the passages? I think we should do the passages. Easy passage, very easy passage to read. Yeah, let us do this one. Lakshya, we'll do one more passage because this is easy. We will not do the fourth passage, we will just do this passage, guys. Done. Yes, 10th one, the easy one, guys. Mark the answer. Yes, Manthan, correct. So he's saying the modern currency shares the following features. So what are the similarities? One is that they were using different materials. They fluctuate in value over time. It's different currencies for different situations, right? So it is undergoing transformation is only in the case of modern currency, not in the case of the Tang currency. So therefore, the answer will be B. There is no transformation implied in these during that era. Whereas in the modern time, there is technology which is taking over, and we are seeing it changing in front of our eyes. It was not the case in that particular era. So that's why answer is B. Okay, coming to 11th one. In the context of the passage, which one of the following can be inferred with regard to the use of currency during the Tang era? 11th one. Yes, Lakshya giving me correct answer. No, guys, currency that deteriorated easily was not used for official work. Yeah, if you look at the paragraph which is trying to tell you the word stable and steady. So what is he telling you that in the third paragraph? So the values of different textiles were also more stable than the fluctuating values of coins, is what he's trying to tell you. And these words will come here. Dimensions of a bolt of silk held steady is what he is trying to say in this particular paragraph, and therefore it is A. The idea of supply can be inferred from the first sentence also, right? So answer therefore is 1. A is the answer. Now, this cannot be inferred. Copper coins were more valuable and durable than textiles. Currency usage was similar to that of the modern times. Sorry, guys. 11th one, answer is C. Currency usage was similar to that of the modern times can be inferred. These cannot be inferred, right? Yes, these cannot be inferred. I was giving the answer of question number 12. When is discussing textiles as currency in the Tang period, the author uses the word steady and stable to indicate all the following except. Which one is the answer to this? Reliable supply, reliable measurement, reliable quality, all of them are mentioned, except reliable transportation is not mentioned. Right? Supply can be inferred from the first sentence. Values of different textiles are more stable because textiles would not have deteriorated over time, and the passage tells you that the value of textiles depended on the quality of the textiles. So all these are mentioned. Reliable transportation is not mentioned. Okay, let us go to this one. Is a tricky question. Tricky. During the Tang period, which one of the following would not be an economically sound decision for a small purchase in the local market that is worth 1/8 of a bolt of cloth? So you have to look for one which is an economically sound decision. Economically, it should be profitable. Yes, what will be the answer, guys? 13th one. So you have to pick the one which would not be. So it's an except question, which is not going to make profit, guys. Yes, these two are economical. Definitely 2 and 3 are very economical. Making payment in grains is an economical way, as grains would rot easily, so the payer will gain when the payee will not, right? And then thus both of them, 2 and 3, are economical. 3 is also economical because the coins, the passage says, lost value over time, but a piece of fabric from a new bolt is more likely to lose value over time. And so it would be economically not a wise decision for the payment. Answer is D. Correct. 13th one is D. Okay, let's go to the questions, guys. It's very long. Please do this passage by yourself and we will understand the questions. Now, you have to do para jumbles. Para jumbles, and you have to give me the entire answer. 19th one. What is the combination? Yes, let's form this paragraph, guys. What is the opening sentence? This is not looking like the opening sentence. Selected tales reveal that they deal. A is the opening sentence. Very good. Relying on narrative structure alone, indigenous significances of 19th century San folk tales are hard to determine. Indigenous means the natives are hard to determine, right? A is the opening. A is followed by correct. Shivangi, A is followed by D. Meaning can be elicited. Elicited means derived. Tales conceptualized by probing beneath the narrative verbatim. Verbatim means word to word. And then you have C. Selected tales that they deal with a form of spiritual conflict has social implication. Conflict between people living or dead malevolent shamans. So answer here is A, D, C, B, using their supernatural potency, right? So A, D, B, C, very good. Let's go to the next question. Identify the odd one out. Odd one out is what you have to do, guys. Let us do this one. Which is the odd man out here? Yes, question number 20. Why not B before C? No, because here is where he is mentioning, in C is mentioning living or dead Molvil and Shamans is first mentioned here. Using their supernatural, benign Shamans transcend the levels. This is the link, CD. Okay, find the odd man out and give me the combination, guys. What is the opening sentence here? Now, let us start forming the paragraph. D is the opening sentence. Freedom of speech, the power to silence, may have been preeminent markers of white liberty in colonies, but at the same time slavery depended on dialogue. Slaves could never be completely muted. You cannot ask them to shut up, right? D is followed by E. Slave owners obsessed over slave talk. This is talking about slave talk. Though they would never control it, they feared its power would blind and inspire. Then, talk was the most common way for enslaved men and women to subvert, that means to avoid the rules of their bondage, to gain agency than they were supposed to have. And lastly, you have B. Even in conditions of extreme violence, their words remain ubiquitous. Ubiquitous is present everywhere. Ephemeral, irrepressible, potentially transgressive. These are the qualities. So, D, E, A, B. Answer is C. Slaves came from societies. Where the slaves came from? All this is talking about freedom of speech. Right? All these are talking about speech. Where the slaves came from and its connection to all powerful spirit world is the odd man out. Okay? Now let us go to question number 21. Again, coherent paragraph, guys. Let me see you form the paragraph. What is the opening sentence? C is the opening sentence. Very good. It is introducing the idea. Since the 1990s, security environment of Southeast Asia has both continuity and changes. This is the topic. Okay, very good. C is followed by not CB, guys. C is followed by A. Tensions and sometimes conflict remain an issue in and between the 11 states. Right? And then you have B. China's rise as a regional military power. So, it is bringing the action from the 1990s to the present. And that is why, if you look at option number 3, I mean that is C, See is in the present perfect continuous tense, and where this is in the simple present tense. This is a present perfect tense, has been both. Yeah, present perfect continuous. Right? And the reason why these two are a pair. Now, why is A and B a pair is because the use of the pronoun. These concerns. So you have C, A, B, D. These concerns. What are the concerns? Concerns are mentioned here. Security concern. Right? So these two are connected with concerns. These two are connected because of the grammar aspect. Right? So C, A, B, D. Let us go to the next one. Summary question. Pick the best summary. Read this paragraph, guys. Yes, we have just few more questions to go. Five more questions. We will just do the summary. And five more questions. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Done. Okay, which is the best summary, guys? 22. So, what is the passage talking about? The passage is saying that modern Europe has done two things in order to adapt. One is establish a common currency and a formal political structure, adjusting its internal differences by peaceful mechanisms. So, C cannot be the answer because these are all specific ideas. Answer is it has chosen to lower political economic heterogeneity in order to adapt itself to an emerging multipolar world. Right? So this is complete. Answer is D, guys. These are all talking about specific points. So if you say Europe has consistently done this. Change its internal structures, successfully adapt to the changing world order. Europe has changed in keeping with the changing world order and has culminated in united Europe. No. Establishment of a political structure was hastened are all part answers. Specific Part answers. They are mentioned somewhere in the passage, but they are not the complete answer. Let us go to 23, guys. Yes, Lakshya. So what is he trying to say is there are two things that he has done. One is the currency. Second is a formal political structure. Yeah, he's talking about establishing a common currency. Yes. Lower has chosen to lower political, that means to lessen the differences in political and economics. So adjusting his internal differences by peaceful mechanisms. So by choosing a common currency, it has tried to lower economic heterogeneity, and by establishing European Union, it has tried to lower political heterogeneity. Yeah. So therefore the answer is D. Let us look at this one. Guys, last three questions. Easy question. This one is easy. Hetero means they have tried to reduce heterogeneity. They have chosen to lower. Lakshya, do you see this? They are trying to lower the political and economic heterogeneity. So by choosing a common currency, it has lowered the economic differences, and by establishing European Union, it has tried to lower political differences. Got it? Okay, let us go to 23, guys. Yes, what is the answer? Very easy answer, come on. No. Yes, Manthan, correct. B is the answer. Movies and televisions have led us to believe that the use of forensic phonetics in legal is robust and foolproof. Yeah, we believe that this is good. Voice recognition alone is not what he is trying to say. It's important to also bring in where. Voice recognition where? It should be in the movies and TV. That is important. So this is incomplete. This is talking about identifying criminals has been used to identify criminals in real life. Also, this comparison is incorrect. Yes, guys, so answer is B. Let's go to 24. Yes, 90% is mentioned. Yes, we are led to believe that it is foolproof. It's not true, right, Abhishek? They have led us to believe that it is robust and foolproof, which it is not. So 90% does not make it foolproof. Yes, I also agree. 90% does not make it foolproof. But we are led to believe. Movies tell us that it is foolproof. Yes, can I go to the options? Question number 24, last three questions. Yes, look for keywords, guys. What are the keywords that you will find in the passage and in the options? So he's talking about two keywords. One is intelligence and the other one is heritability. Heritability, right? So answer therefore is A. So this is not talking about heritability. This is not mentioned in the second one. This is talking about ways in which it is inherited, in what is inherited. This makes it incorrect. So the criticism is about heritability itself and not the ways in which it is inherited. And this also is not talking about heritability. Right, so therefore the answer is A. Let us go to 25, guys. Odd one out, last two questions. 25 and 26, last two questions. Inextricably means cannot be extricated, like something which is entangled. So it becomes all entangled and it cannot be extricated. So let us form the paragraph, guys. This is a little complicated. You start with E. The feminist inquiry into the activity of reading begins with the realization that literally canon means principle, is androcentric and that this has profoundly damaging effect on women readers. So it is more dependent upon men. So that is why E is followed by A. For feminists, the questions of how we read is linked with the question of what we read. So EA therefore is a link. The documentation of this realization, this is the realization is mentioned in D, is one of the earlier tasks undertaken by feminist critics. And this is the critique of the curriculum is an exemplary work. This is an example of the work. So therefore, answer is C. This is talking about endocentric literature structures, the reading experience depending on the gender of the reader is talking about endocentric literature. So EADB, guys. Okay, let's do the last question, question number 26. We have to do the para jumble. Can you form the paragraph? Yes, what is the opening sentence? This one is an easy one, guys. Easy para jumble. So let me help you. A is the opening sentence. Man has used poison for assassination. Killing people by way of poison ever since the dawn of civilization. Since the dawn of civilization itself, against individual enemies, but also against armies. Right. So A is the opening sentence. A is followed by. Yes, Arjun, come on. A is followed by C. So this foundation, new prospects of those interested in biological weapons, followed by C. These dangers were soon recognized. And lastly, you have D. Though treaties were made in good faith, they contained no means of control, so failed to prevent interested parties from developing biological weapons. So A, C, B, D is the combination, guys. So you got it? Okay, I think the CAT papers are quite heavy and students are losing interest very fast. Maybe it is better to do passages one day and the verbal ability one day, guys, instead of doing the whole thing on the same day. I think it's not working out to do all 26 questions in the same class. So we will divide it into 13 questions. From tomorrow onwards. So when I take one particular previous year's papers, we'll try to do 10 to 13 questions in each class. Is that fine, guys? Yeah. So please go ahead and download the Unacademy Learning app from Google Play or App Store. Steps to get subscription is you can go to CAT and you can click on plus. You have many CAT courses. You can get your subscription. Subscribe, like, share. Hashtag CAT Live Daily. My referral code is CORE10, guys. Please use CORE10 in order to get a 10% discount.